I really had intended to do some Facebook Lives with food and with lifestyle stuff. That's a little bit bright. With lifestyle stuff while we were on our travels, and the internet was not cooperating with me. Didn't have enough signal to actually do videos. So I kind of gave up and just had a good time on my vacation. So I am back. And one of the things that I loved, 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 we stayed, we were in Italy for part of that. We were gone for like a month. We were in Italy for a ski trip. And we stayed at a mountain hut that you had to ski, you had to take the chairlift up and then ski down to the hut. And if you missed the last chairlift, you ended up having to call them to pick you up with a snowmobile and pay them $25 a person to do that. So it was really remote. It was really cool. It was lovely. They made their own pizzas and Italian pizzas. Lots of Italian food is, when you think of Italian food, you think of pizzas, you think of pastas. But one of my favorite things, this hut, if you want to know where this hut is, oh my gosh, it's the most fabulous thing if you want to go skiing or if you want to go hiking in the summer, Northern Italy and the Dolomites, you got to do it. It's beautiful. But we had, as part of our lodging, it was a bed and breakfast kind of a situation. So with our lodging, we had a four-course dinner every night, and we had a full breakfast. Kind of serve yourself, but they had a juicer, they had a little egg cooker, they had a espresso machine. Heavenly, it was great. And almost every dinner, they had an antipasto as one of the courses, and that was with lots of salads on the table, and you could choose. They had a lot of cold veggies. So if you're here, pop a note down below and say hi. If you catch us on the replay, pop a replay on there. Hey, Patty. And we'll join the party. So this party is going to be an Italian party for coleslaw. So what is so special about this? Italian coleslaw, I just couldn't get enough of this stuff. One, it's got super vitamin C. Now, it is getting to be spring, and this is a fall, winter vegetable. But there are not a lot of things growing, and this is still a vibrant food to consider. The special thing about this coleslaw is that it's really light. It does have some oil in it. It has no mayo in it, and it just has beautiful, beautiful blend of herbs and spices in it. And it's very simple, actually. Not simple in the few ingredients. There are more ingredients. Hi, Steve. So we're just going to chop this up, and I've been peeling, and I was thinking about chopping it up ahead of time, but I don't know, maybe you want some tips on how to chop up a cabbage nicely for coleslaw. I do not use my food processor for this. I do use it by hand, so I cut it into halves. I do peel the outer leaves, cut it into halves, cut it into quarters, and then see this little core here? We just kind of triangle that off like that. I'm putting everything in the sink right now that is going to go in our compost. Now, I usually cut an eighth because I don't like really long pieces of coleslaw. So it's my texture. You can certainly do it in quarters if you want to, but I like eighths like this. And then I cut it in quarters. Hi, Joel. So I cut it in quarters, and then you can cut it any thickness you want. I cut it a little bit at an angle like this so that I get kind of an arc going, so I don't have any pieces that are really super thick. I like them about like this. It's totally up to you. You can do a fine cut, you can do a thick cut, whatever texture you want. It's the really nice thing about coleslaw. It can be very individualized. When I cut cabbage up for sauerkraut, I usually cut it a little thinner. So if you're here, just pop in there that you're here. I may not cut this whole cabbage up to show you because I don't want it to take forever. So this trip to the Dolomites, they don't have a lot of, obviously it's winter there, they don't have a lot of fresh veggies going either. And strangely enough, when they served us this antipasto, they served a lot of cooked cold vegetables, which was, I thought that was a little unusual. But it was, we put it in a salad bowl and we ate it with salad dressing on it. It was kind of a fun little experiment. So Then we'll do this other half, and I think then we'll put in the seasoning so we can all get on with our day, and you can assume that the whole cabbage is going in there. So when you use a knife, I'm not using it properly. I'm not a knife expert, but when you use a knife, you put your thumb and forefinger on the metal knife itself and the rest on the handle, and that way you protect yourself a little more for managing the knife and cutting properly. When this gets a little too thin on one side, we'll turn it the other way. And maybe some of these won't be so beautifully chopped. So, shall I, let's see. Oh, it is, it's really easy. It's really easy. And yes, you can keep this in the fridge and pull it out every day for like 2 weeks probably. Well, it won't last more than a week, I pretty much guarantee you. But yeah, this is something that you can store in the refrigerator for a good length of time. So once you make it, this is one of those things you can make once a week and have just easy to grab in the fridge. I love salads like that. Other salads that I like that are bean salad, tabbouleh salad, and we'll make some of those as it gets into spring. So here I am, I'm making myself a liar because I'm getting inspired here. I just finished a video for my Release and Energize group. We're doing a clearing release and energize for 21 days. If you would like to join, pop I'm in down below. We're on day two. And day two was to clean the refrigerator out. So I'm super motivated from doing that. And in the findings that I had with that, there were a couple of wrinkled peppers. And now we're having fajitas tonight. So there's just more inspiration in the kitchen today. And that's kind of nice. Now, I do have an agenda today for actual work. This is fun. So, almost done with this, and then we'll get right into the seasoning. So, the recipe calls for white vinegar. I'm not a big fan of white vinegar, and they do that because it looks clean and pure, but I'm going to use the Bragg's vinegar with a mother just because I can. And you can choose. You can do a white vinegar if you want to. So here we have. Okay, there's the beginning of our coleslaw. So, and if you just joined us, pop on in below and say hi. So our first ingredient is going to be, this is the Bragg's vinegar with the mother. So this is a probiotic. So this is really good for your gut. That's one of the reasons. White vinegar I use for cleaning. It's purified, it's distilled. There isn't a lot of nutritional value to it. It is an acid, but acids aren't really good for us. It does go into our system and turn alkaline, but it doesn't have a lot of nutritional value. This has nutritional value with a probiotic. So there's a half cup of this, and I will post the recipe after this. So we're just gonna blend this in here. And then, oh, I love this olive oil. If you need to find a good brand of olive oil, and sorry I didn't turn this around. I don't know if I can right now or not. Let me see if I can. No. Yeah, I did. Cool. Okay. So, I'll get back over there. So, this is my favorite olive oil, and they have several, oh my gosh, they have several flavors too. I'll show you a couple of them. We have, if you like to dip olive oil, like with bread and stuff, here are a couple of flavors that I'll get this right. I'm backwards now. So these are two flavors that they have. We love these. You can see which one we started with, and it's almost gone. So I'm gonna have to get some more. But we keep these on hand. So these are really wonderful for salads. Now, because this is a big salad, because I'm using it's a quarter cup. Should I or shouldn't I? The bold and peppery. I'm gonna use the regular. Now the regular, and they even tell you, the everyday, where you can see this. So the everyday extra virgin olive oil, this is cold pressed, it's wonderful. It's one of the better olive oils that you can get at a regular grocery store and not have to order or get custom sent to you. So we're gonna do a quarter cup of the olive oil in here. And it just smells really good. It's fresh. You do not want to ever use a rancid oil. Always use an olive oil for salads. And then let's see, where's my recipe? I know we have. This is what was the one, probably the most special part of it, is the caraway seeds. Now we got a tablespoon of caraway seeds in here. Hi, Allison. So a tablespoon of caraway seeds, this really makes it. And if you want to really bring the flavor out, if you have a mortar and pestle, you can lightly bruise them by running this around in here. And by bruising that, you can also crush it with your hands or roll it with a rolling pin. You don't have to do this. This is like an extra thing. But that brings out a little more of the flavor of the herbs. Now, I use my mortar and pestle more than I ever thought I would. I use it for crushing all sorts of things. Now, I was not planning ahead, and this calls for garlic powder. Now, how much garlic powder I have is very minimal. I'm going to see how much I have. It's not going to be a lot. It's probably half a teaspoon. And we need a tablespoon. So now's the time to go, oh my gosh, now what do? I don't have all the things. So I'm going to put that in there. And that's garlic powder. So the rest of it, I'm going to use real garlic. There's nothing wrong with real garlic. Now, I have to estimate a tablespoon of garlic powder. It's pretty concentrated, so I'm probably going to use about a half a tablespoon of fresh garlic. It's going to be a little bit different flavor, but it's going to be a stronger flavor. So that will probably suffice. I can always add more later if I want to. And then next we have a salt. Now the salt I use is a sea salt, and this has all the minerals in it too. This is the one that I like. We have a Vitamin Cottage Natural Grocers, and they have the Orso or Orlo something salt that's pretty similar. And we want a teaspoon of this. And again, I'll post the recipe after we finish this. Teaspoon of that. Then we've got pepper. Now, pepper, when I use pepper, I never measure it, but I have a really nice grinder. You want fresh ground pepper whenever possible because the flavor is so much stronger. And telecherry pepper is the best, the most flavorful, and the most nutritious if you're looking for a nutritional aspect. Pepper is also one of those things when you have turmeric that you always want to add pepper to it because it activates it. Pepper is a really good thing for activating your metabolism. And that was, I don't know, let's see. I guess I should count by the seconds what my measurement is, but it's supposed to be about a half a teaspoon. We got the vinegar, we got the olive oil. Now, I just cleaned the refrigerator and I found 2 Dijon mustards, so I am emptying one into the other. And we want to have a teaspoon of the Dijon. And I could squirt this out. And it doesn't have to be exact. This is going to be to your taste. And then, let's see. I am going to use from the clean dishwasher that I haven't unloaded yet. I'm going to use, there's a big chunk of cabbage here. So I'm going to use this long fork so I keep everything in the bowl. And this is something that you're not going to eat in the first 5 minutes that you make it. It does need to set for at least an hour, and the longer the better, actually. It's going to soak into the leaves and all the cuts. One of the reasons that you cut so much when you make coleslaw is that you want to open up the pores. You want to open up those cells of the leaves so that it starts to absorb what you're adding to it. So it's really starting to have a nice blend here. And now the only other thing that you want to do, this smells so good. I want to have this for lunch, like really soon. So what you want to do right before you eat it, if you like, they did not do this at our hut, but this is in the recipe, and I may even try it. This is the first time I've made this recipe. I may even try it just like half and half and just keep it in storage and see what happens. But it's to squeeze fresh lemon juice onto the top before you eat it. So, well, let's see. Get it out of there. There we go. Beautiful, beautiful coleslaw. Hi, Kathleen. So, it smells so good. So I hope that you try this. I would love your feedback. If you have questions, what did I forget? I told you probably more than I meant to. Of course, I do that all the time. So I apologize for not being able to do more Facebook Lives with food while I was in Italy, because it would have been super fun. It wouldn't even do like a 10-second video. I was so frustrated. But we're back on track. We're going to be doing some spring foods. Oh, it smells even better than it looks, Joelle. So give this a try. This can keep in your refrigerator for at least a week if you don't eat it all up that fast. I have a feeling this is going to be gone by Saturday, maybe sooner. So that's our Italian coleslaw. I will post the recipe as soon as I finish this and get it posted. I'll post it right up in the lead so that you have that and you can get started. Or you can watch the video, and I think I set all the measurements in there too. Anyway, I will see you on Friday. We'll do a lifestyle video on Friday. I'm thinking of changing the day to a different day, but we're going to plan on Friday for now for a lifestyle Friday video. And if you want to join it's a free 21-day clearing, release, and energize. I'm not sure if it's a program or if it's a challenge. I'm doing it right on the Facebook group. It's a special Facebook group called Release and Energize Health. And if you put down in below, just in the comments, I will add you to that group and you can start. We are on day two. We just did two activities so far. It's going really well and it's easy to do, 10 minutes or less a day. So if you would like to join that, put in down below and we'll add you and get you started, and you can backtrack if you want to do the other pieces. I will see you on Friday. Have a wonderful week. Bye-bye for now.